You are among the rare humans who have come to appreciate the contrast of your time and place. We like to begin in that way because we remember something that many of our physical friends do not remember, and that is the enthusiasm with which you made the decision to come forth into this time-space reality. And the factor that was the most exhilarating about creating here, about being here in this leading edge environment, was the variety or contrast that you knew you would be able to choose from. From your non-physical perspective, you know that you are creator. And you knew before you made the decision to come forth into these bodies that what that meant is you would be one who focuses. You knew from your non-physical perspective that everything is about vibration, that you are more electrical beings than you are the flesh, blood, and bone beings that you see here. And you were excited about the idea of having tremendous variety to ponder and consider and to conclude from. And from that non-physical perspective, you knew that that conclusion or that decision or that intention, that determination, that focus that would be natural, you knew that that would be a flashpoint, a summoning point. You knew that in that decision there would be pulling power. And you knew at that time, you're coming to know it or remember it again now, you knew that in the conclusion or in the deciding or in the desiring, that there would be a summoning, because you understood from that perspective that everything is about law of attraction. And you knew that when a desire was formulated within you, that that desire would summon unto you, that your desires would be created through you. You knew that when you ask, it is always given. Sometimes when we talk about asking, we know that our physical friends think that what we mean by that is the asking that comes from your words. And while sometimes you do ask with your words, it is not that asking that we are wanting to call your attention to. It is a vibrational asking. It is the natural impulse of desire. It is the desire that exists within you that is born out of that which you are perusing, that which you are considering. It is that decision that is made even without the words that you are offering. Sometimes you ask with your words. And what we mean by that is sometimes the words that you are speaking are a perfect vibrational match to the vibration that is within you. But very often, the asking that is going on vibrationally is not the asking that you think it is. We're wanting to help you to understand how it is that you are asking and why it is that you are getting, or why it is you are not getting what it is you are wanting. We're wanting you to understand that you are vibrational beings and you are focused in a vibrational universe. And when you are understanding the vibration that you are offering, then you understand the manifestation that is coming. An easy way to hear that is what I am thinking and what I am receiving are always a vibrational match. An even better way of saying it is what I am thinking or pondering or remembering or imagining or musing or considering or focusing upon, that which I'm giving my attention to, is causing an emotional reaction within me. And that emotional reaction within me is my indicator of my vibration. So it is always true that what I'm thinking and feeling and what is manifesting is always a match. Sometimes we see you and you say, I want to know how to offer the perfect vibration so that I can create or manifest the perfect life experience. And we say, we think that's a very good idea. That's what deliberate creating is. But we also think that it is equally important for you to relax and lighten up and begin to observe the content of your manifestation in order to more fully understand what your vibrational offering is. Because when you begin to make that correlation, when you begin to get it, that what's coming to you in terms of actualization or manifestation is always a perfect vibrational match to what you've been feeling, then as you begin to pay more attention to that which you've been feeling, you can understand more clearly what's coming. And the best part of that is, once you begin to understand that what comes in response to vibrational offering, and you begin to learn how to deliberately offer your vibrational offering, now you are really in this place of deliberate creating. So as you have an experience that gives you a better idea of what you are wanting, that wanting is a sort of birthing of idea. And when that idea is born within you, there is power. That is the nugget of the universe when that new conclusion is formed within you. And in the moment that idea bursts forth within you, non-physical energy rushes to answer it, because it is always true every time that when you ask, it is always given. Sometimes people say to us, Abraham, you're teaching us fantasy, you're teaching us denial, you're teaching us fabrication, you're teaching us fiction. And we say, we're teaching you to set your vibrational tone. Because when you set your vibrational tone to something that pleases you, the universe will yield to you something that pleases you. Sometimes people will say to us, but Abraham, should I not face reality? And we say, no, never face reality unless what you are living is perfect in every way, then give it your full attention. But what we would do is selectively sift. We would selectively sift through our reality, and we would focus mostly upon those things that please us. Then people say to us, Abraham, well, you are teaching selfishness. And we say, indeed we are. Because if you are not selfish enough to find vibrational harmony with Source, then you have nothing to give anyone else anyway. If you are not paying attention to the way you feel, then you have no basis of knowing which direction to go. What many physical beings are doing is they are looking at the results of the manifestations, and they say, these are good manifestations, we want more of them, we would vote for those. But these are bad manifestations, we want not these, we would not vote for these. And so as they are saying yes to these things, but no to these things, they have a sort of mix of vibration that is not a vibrational match to what they are really wanting. And so the universe cannot yield to them what they are really wanting, because they are not a vibrational match to what they are really wanting. And law of attraction says, that which is likened to itself is drawn. So here's what we would do if we were standing in your physical shoes. We would make a decision that nothing is more important than that I feel good. Because the way I feel is my true indicator of my vibrational harmony or my vibrational alignment with the non-physical energy. So how does one go about achieving vibrational harmony with well-being? Well, little by little, you reach for thoughts that feel good. In other words, it is an incremental thing. You did not get to the place of not letting it in completely overnight. In other words, it was one thought that you picked up along your physical trail at a time. So for the most part, we encourage just picking up more thoughts that feel good. But you have to be selfish enough to say, nothing is more important than that I feel good. A good mantra is, today, no matter where I'm going, no matter what I'm doing, no matter who I'm doing it with, it is my dominant intent to look for that which I'm wanting to see. I'm wanting to look for that which makes me feel good when I see it. And as you begin to be a more deliberate, selective sifter, where you look for things to appreciate, or you look for things to compliment on, or you look for things to bask about, you look for reasons to feel good. As you look for reasons to feel good, you find reasons to feel good. And as you find reasons to feel good, you feel good. And as you feel good, you let it in. As you feel good, you let clarity in. As you feel good, you let abundance of well-being, abundance of all things that you consider to be good, you let in.